It was sometime between 4:30 and 5 a.m. I'm not exactly sure the first time we heard the gunshots. It sounded like an automatic weapon. And it was very loud, and it woke me up. It woke us up, and you know, we didn't do anything to start with because you just wake up after you've heard that. Well, then we waited a few minutes, and it happened again, and so we called 911.
The first time you heard it, how many shots did you hear in a row?
I think it was, I didn't really count them, sure. But it was about probably 8 to 12.
Okay.
You know, it was bam, 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 like that. And it was very loud.
And then do you have a sense of how much time between
the second time?
How much time elapsed between the first burst and the second time you heard it?
You know, it seemed like it was probably longer than it actually was, you know, and so maybe it was 5 minutes,
maybe
10.
Okay.
And then it happened again, and then we called 911. Well, then it happened the third time, and we called 911 back again, just to make sure. And there were responders who had already come down there after we called the first time. And we looked out the window, and there was this white RV that was parked just across the street.
Mm-hmm.
And so it started playing this message, evacuate now. This vehicle contains a bomb and it will explode. And I think they may have been playing some other things. It was a mechanized woman's voice. It was computerized.
Mm-hmm.
So
it didn't sound like a woman had recorded it herself. It sounded somehow computerized.
It sounded like it was a computerized thing. You know, how you have those automated
sure.
calls and you have automated stuff. And that's what it sounded like. And that went on for a good long while, because by that time we called 911 again, wanting to know what should we do, you know.
And what did they tell you?
What should we do? And they were trying to get information from the police who were down there to try and figure out what they needed to tell us. Well, in the meantime, we started gathering up our stuff. I had to get my cat. I had my 85-year-old sister who was staying in another apartment. We run short-term rentals on this floor, and we didn't have any guests. But my son was visiting up here, my sister visiting here, and they were in two different apartments.
Mm-hmm.
And from the one that I've lived in for 15 years. And so then they started the countdown. And
do you know,
sorry to interrupt, evacuate now.
Do you know what time the countdown started roughly?
I think the countdown probably started sometime around 10 till 6.
Okay.
Or 5 till 6, something like that, because we, at 11, when there were still 11 minutes left, we got on the elevator and went downstairs, and by the time we got to our garage where our car was parked on First Avenue, the last thing we heard was there were 8 minutes left to evacuate. And
so the recording is counting down minute by minute?
Yes, it was counting down. It was saying, you have 15 minutes to evacuate, and then, you know, and it would say that over and over, and then you have 14 minutes to evacuate.
So sorry to interrupt, but just to be clear, so when it would say you have 15 minutes to evacuate, it would say that over and over over the course of a minute, and then it would say you have 14 minutes, and it would say that over and over?
Yes, yes.
Wow. That must be terrifying.
All the way down, and I didn't hear it anymore after 8 minutes because we were in the car.
I mean, that must be terrifying.
It was absolutely terrifying. And I mean, and you know, I told my family yesterday, I said, you know, I think I'm just going to spend all day Christmas in my pajamas. But, you know, I didn't mean that I wasn't going to have anything else to put on because we walked out of there with our pajamas and our cat.
This is not how you expected to spend the day in your pajamas. You're expecting a more relaxing day.
Right. You know, and we had all of our Christmas stuff set up. And in fact, our Christmas tree and everything is in the apartment that overlooks the river. It's a larger apartment that overlooks the Cumberland River. And so we went back around there after the explosion because we left. You know, what happened was that, I'm sorry, I didn't finish this. You know, the countdown started and we went and got in our car and we left and went across the river to Nissan Stadium and parked there for several minutes. And after we knew that the time had passed where the bomb was going to go off, I mean, the 15 minutes had passed, we went, well, that must have just been somebody's sick idea of a joke. And we got back on Korean Veterans Boulevard and turned down Second Avenue, heading north to come back down there because we were thinking, you know, we'll just go home. And of course, then the bomb exploded while we were on our way back down there. And we saw that thing, the fireball went all the way up past the AT&T, above the AT&T building. Everything just, I mean, everything shook. It was quite the blast.